The skies over this park in New York City have been filled with kites in recent months. On the ground, Afghan, Indian, Pakistani, and other South Asian devotees of kite fighting battle for supremacy of the skies. Bangladeshi Kaiser Khan.
It's like a very special, I got this from my father, from my childhood age. This is the only thing I've been doing it since the very young age.
Shuryar Chowdhury, director of the World Control Board of Kite Flying, says kite fighting is a highly competitive sport, but it is also considered an art form across South Asia, a touchstone of shared experience.
It's not only a sport, it's also a culture. It's a very big part of Pakistani Indian culture. And, you know, it keeps you basically in touch with your culture that you left home and you're here now. But, you know, all the guys and families come out to the park and they fly kites. It's basically a way of staying in touch with your heritage.
Introduced in the U.S. just over a decade ago, kite fighting has been on the ascent ever since. But with the 2004 publication of the novel The Kite Runner by Afghan-American author Khalid Hosseini, kite fighter Rizwan Bassett says the sport has really taken off.
No matter what, even if it's windy, rainy, sunny, they're here Saturday and Sundays flying kites. And personally, we started 12 years ago. I was like one of the three people that were here, started this sport. Now we have, mashallah, a bunch of people.
It takes two men to operate the kite. Mastery of the sky goes to the team whose kite line cuts the cord of its challenger, sending the defeated kite into a free fall.
It's like winning a match, you know, like when two kites have a match together, like, you know, one of them gonna cut, and whosoever cut the kite, he wins the match.
These experienced hands know how to prepare their kite strings with powdered glass and glue to snap their opponent's line, and they understand that winning takes patience, strategy, and some luck. Jim Bertel, VOA News.